Hi, boys and girls. Well, we've got another book about matter, and it's called It's Science, my favorite subject. Solid, liquid, or gas? I wonder, looking at this image, if it is a solid, a liquid, or gas. Or maybe it could be all three. When I think about the glass, that's solid. When I think about the soda that's in the glass, that's liquid. And when I think about the little bubbles rising up and popping, that's a gas. So this picture here has solid, liquid, and gas in here. So we answered the question, solid, liquid, or gas? It's all of them. It's all three. It's the solid glass, the liquid drink, and the gas bubbles popping out of there. Great! Good science, team. Ooh, here's another one. Solid, liquid, or gas? Well, we know the plastic bin and the rubber duck, those are solid. We know the water that he's floating in, that's a liquid. And the air that is inside the rubber duck to keep it floating, well, that's a gas. So it's all three again. Awesome. We're pretty good at this. Table of contents. I'm wrinkling my brain. We're going to get some information out of our book. Down here, I can find the subject. And down here, I can find the number of the page where I will find the information I'm looking for. Useful materials. This all looks pretty useful to me. The things we use and see around us are made of all kinds of different materials. Bricks, metal, and glass are all materials that are good for building. They are all solid. You got it. Can you spot the bricks, metal, and glass in the building? How has each been used? So can you see the bricks, the glass, and the metal in that building? And how is it being used? Cardboard, string, plastic, and cotton balls are not good for making real buildings, but they are useful materials. Why are they useful? These pictures will give you some idea. Why are cotton balls, cardboard, and string useful? They are solids, but I wouldn't want to build a house out of them. Pouring. Oil, liquid soap, honey, and water are different kinds of liquids. Liquids can be poured. Liquid does not have a shape of its own. Look what happens when the same amount of water is poured into these different shaped containers. See, she's used different shaped containers. The water fills up the space and becomes the same shape as the container. Salt and flour are not liquids, but they can be poured because they are made up of thousands of teeny tiny grains. So when you pour flour into a container, like a measuring cup, it looks like it's a liquid, but it's just that the solids are so teeny tiny small that they kind of flow over each other. Gas. Did you know that air is a kind of gas? Well, we can't see it, but it is all around us. You breathe air in and out of your lungs. This balloon is filled with a gas called helium. Helium is lighter than air, so the balloon floats up. Hot air is lighter than cold air, so a hot air balloon goes up and cold air comes down. A car engine burns fuel and gives off a kind of gas called exhaust. A burning fire gives off a kind of gas that is called smoke. At first you can see smoke and exhaust, and then they mix into the air and you can't see them anymore. We burn natural gas for cooking and keeping warm. So on this page, there are lots of different kinds of gases. Water. Water is very important liquid. We need to drink water to stay healthy and to wash in to keep clean. Plants need water to grow. Water is not always a liquid. When it is cooled and frozen cold, it freezes and becomes ice. Ice is a solid. When water is heated up, it becomes steam. Steam is a gas. An iceberg is a giant block of frozen water. When the sun warms it, the ice melts back into water and mixes with the sea. Water test. Some things will float and some things will sink when you put them in water. The duck floats, and so do these things. Marbles, a spoon, and a pebble sink. Look at the different objects on this page. Do you think they are heavy or light? Do you know what they're made of? We've done floating and sinking before, haven't we? We did that ages ago. So we know a lot about things that are light and trap air and will float, and things that have no air pockets and are heavy and sink. When you put some materials in water, they soak up the water and feel soggy. Other materials don't soak up the water at all. They are waterproof. So they've got some items there to try. Piece of paper, some yarn, a sponge, and a plastic bag, whether they absorb water or not. Melting. Butter, chocolate, and wax are solids. When they're heated, they melt and they become a liquid. They become solid again when they cool down. Plastic melts and becomes soft and runny when it is heated. Melted plastic can be poured into a mold. When it cools down, it sets into the shape of the mold. Look around you to find some things like these that are made of molded plastic. Metal melts when it's heated to very high temperatures. Molten metal was poured into a mold to make this metal toy truck. So I found some plastic that had been melted and then made into my plastic cup. I'm sure you can find some plastic in your house that has been melted down, put into a mold, and then made into something. Changing shape. Clay is a kind of mud. You can squish it, press it, and roll it into new shapes. When the clay is fired in a kiln, it dries out and becomes hard. You can't change the shape of a fired pot unless you smash it. Pastry dough is soft and can be made into new shapes. When the pastry dough is cooked, it hardens and it becomes great to eat. Thin sheets of metal can be cut and hammered and pressed into new shapes. You can curl, twist, and bend wire. It is good for making models because it will hold its new shape. Dissolving. If you look at salt and sugar through a magnifying glass, you will see hundreds and hundreds of tiny crystals. Salt and sugar crystals dissolve when they are mixed with water, and they make a solution. Look what happens when you mix cooking oil with water. It breaks up, but it will not dissolve whenever you stir it. So cooking oil will not dissolve, but sugar and salt will. That's pretty interesting. You should try that out. Paper. Did you know that paper is made from teeny tiny pieces of wood mixed with water to make wood pulp? The pulp is then squeezed out and rolled to make sheets of paper. Which paper on the opposite page would you use to write a letter? I don't think I'd use a paper towel or this curly butcher paper or this lightweight tissue paper. I think I would use the pad of lined paper. Which paper would you use to wrap a present? Oh, probably the wrapping paper or this wrapping paper. I could wrap it in a paper towel, but I don't think it would look very good. Which paper would be good for mopping up? Definitely the paper towel, because it would absorb the liquid. Which paper could you use to wrap your sandwiches? Oh, probably this wax paper, because it would help keep my sandwiches fresh. What material? Do you know what this dining room chair is made out of? Definitely a solid. It looks like it might be wooden. What do you think? How about this baby bowl and baby cup? What do you think they're made out of? How about the pot with the glass in the window? What do you think? Wood can be cut and carved. It is strong, but it burns easily. Metal is strong and does not burn easily. Plastic is tough and light, and it can be molded into different shapes. You can see through glass, but it breaks easily. So lots of different materials. Take a look around your house and see what kind of materials your things are made out of. Are they made out of wood or metal or plastic or glass? Natural or man-made? Some of the materials we use are natural. They come from animals, plants, or from the ground. Wool comes from a sheep. Wood comes from trees. Marble is a kind of rock. And some rocks have gold in them. Natural materials can be used to make different kinds of materials. Oil from deep under the ground is used to make nylon. Sand is one of the materials used to make glass. Oh, so take a look at these items. What do you think they're made out of? And then here's a bunch of useful words that we used in this book. So your job today, scientists, is to find an item in your house and then tell us about it. Describe it to us. So, for example, I have a test tube. What is my item made of? Sounds like it's made of plastic. So I would draw my item and then label it with the word plastic. And I could use my sounding out skills. My item is hard, so I would use the word hard to describe it. Hard. My item is, it's see-through. It's transparent. So I would put clear. I can see clearly through it. My item is solid, so I could describe it as a solid. My item is man-made. Somebody made this, and it wasn't nature. So those are some things that I could describe it as. Oh, it's also a cylinder, a 3D shape. That's something else I could describe it as. So find an item in your house. Figure out if it's natural, man-made. What does it feel like? What's it made of? What is its color? What is its shape? Go ahead, find an item and describe it in your journal.